And now we will learn how to use the deposit detail report. It's mostly used when you edit a deposit. The deposit detail is a report that shows every deposit that you ever made into every bank account since the creation of the file. It shows the specific payments and receipts that have been deposited from undeposited funds. It will help you edit a deposit. Now, let's just take a quick look at the report itself. If you click the Reports area, and you click All Reports, make sure that you don't have to click it again on the left. You can go down to Review Sales. And I know that it's a little unusual that a deposit report would be in Review Sales, but it does relate to sales. And after you click Review Sales for this category of report, go all the way down to the bottom center and you can click on Deposit Detail. Now, of course, the date range that it defaults is the current month to date. However, it's best to click All Dates and then click Run the Report. Now, this is showing every deposit to every bank account since the beginning of the file if you put All Dates for the time period. Now, in order to get the deposits or to see the deposits that we made in the recent video, you would have to scroll all the way to the bottom. Now here are the last two at the bottom, and these are the ones that we made in the previous video. Notice it has three money amounts rather than one. For example, the February 28th, it has the total as a positive number, and it has the individual items as negative numbers. We can see the deposit by double-clicking right here on the word deposit, and we can see exactly what we put. Here are the two items, and we can find out the details of what they are, and here's the total. Okay, if we close this out, we can look at the deposit before that. Here are the two items in negative, and you can see the positive number is the total deposit. Click on the deposit for February 27, and you can see more detail about the two specific items that were deposited on February 27. Now let's take a look at these other three deposits here. These other three deposits were from the video before that when I was showing cash back. This is the deposit and this is what it looks like when you get cash back. It shows the total deposit and it shows the individual items that were cash back. This was the income you earned. These were the two expenses. This is whom you earned the income from. These are the vendors whom you paid to. And this was the total deposit. And I could click on it and take a look. Same thing about the deposit before that and so on. However, if you keep going up, you will see on the deposit report payments and sales receipts. Well, why would you see payments and sales receipts on a report that's clearly marked deposit detail? Any payment or sale receipt on this report was money that we received that was directly deposited into the bank account. Let me show you. If I click a sale receipt as a loan deposit on this report, you will see that this was deposited directly to cash in bank and not to undeposited funds. Same thing with this payment. For an invoice, when Betty paid us for an invoice payment. This payment was paid directly into the bank account and not put in undeposited funds. So we close it out. So that explains why individual payments and individual sales receipts are sometimes listed on the deposit report. But if it says deposit, you can bet that there's several receipts or payments together in one deposit. Now it's very easy to remove an item from the deposit. Open the deposit, remove the check mark next to the item that should not be a part of the deposit. The item will then appear as available and added to future, available to be added to future deposits, and it will immediately be put back in undeposited funds. To add an item to a deposit, open the deposit that you want to add the item to, find the item by looking at the ones that are still unchecked, and then place the check mark next to the item you want to add. So I'm going to give you a simple example of both removing an item from a deposit and adding an item to a deposit. Here's the simple example. Let's remove check number 1717 from candy from the February 27th deposit. Well, that's very simple. The report shows us the February 27th deposit. That's these numbers with candy. When I click the deposit, I can see there are only two items that were deposited on February 27th, and I want to remove this. I want to tell QuickBooks this was not deposited with the February 27th deposit. Well, all I have to do is click this check mark, and this $1,400 will go back to undeposited funds. Undeposited funds is empty right now, but if I remove the check mark and I click save and close, you can bet that when we go back to the report, you can see February 27th no longer has that check. It only has $1,000. Look, let's take a look at the February 27th deposit. You can see it only has one item, this $1,000 check, and this other item is sitting here available to be added to this or any other deposit. I also would like you to take a quick look at the reports. And I'd like you to see our trial balance for a moment. At this moment, you can now see that undeposited funds now has the $1,400, whereas a moment ago, undeposited funds was empty. But once we remove the check mark and we take it out of a deposit, it goes right back into undeposited funds. Now, let's add that check number 1717 to the February 28th deposit. Well, that's just as easy. Here we are back at the deposit report running for all dates and go to the bottom. That makes it easy to find the February 28th deposit. If we click to open it up, what we will see is the deposit that we made. And as you can see, these are the two items that were on the deposit when we made it on February 28th. And what QuickBooks is showing is any extra items and undeposited funds that are lying around and not yet deposited, like this check number 1717. So a moment ago, we took it out of a previous deposit. So any other deposit that we open up will show the ones that were deposited and anything that's not yet deposited. Why does it show it that way? Because all you have to do is click the check mark and congratulations, you have added that free item to this February 28th deposit. Save and close. Now, when we go back, we can see that this is the new amount and the new details of the February 28th deposit, and that's what the February 27th deposit looks like. But let's not leave it this way. Let's correct it before our final exercise. Well, that's very simple. Go back to the deposit that you added it to, and you remove the check mark to say this is not really part of the February 28th deposit. Save and close. And now we can reopen the correct deposit for February 27th, and we can add it back to where it was. Save and close, and our numbers are correct. And now you can manage any issue regarding bank deposits.